My apologies about that. My camera had stopped because my memory was full. I had to delete some videos on it, so we're going to continue. This is the book of Isaiah 31:1. Woe to them that go down to Egypt for help and stay on horses and trust in chariots, because they are many, and in horsemen, because they are very strong, but they look not unto the Holy One of Israel, neither seek the Lord. And that's what our people do, man. They depend on America. You see, the America has a strong army, as you would call it. We're the greatest country in the world, blah, blah, blah. Okay? And because you've become so confident, so arrogant towards carnal matters, you don't even seek to the Lord. You don't seek to the Lord for help, man. And because of that, the Lord is not going to fight for you in the times to come. It's going to get bad out here, man. A lot of people are going to die. No, but it's justified. It makes sense. The Lord gave out an order. He created you Israelites not to do what you wanted to do, but He created you Israelites for His purpose, for His sake. And here you go doing things how you want to do them, and then you think there's no consequences. You run to the so-called white man for all your problems. You women run to Esau for child support. You run to Esau for Section 8. Run to Esau for food stamps. You run to Esau for everything. And don't get me wrong, the scriptures did say you will go to your enemy for one of all things. Yeah, we have to go to Esau for our clothes and food and all that. But at the same time, we don't put our trust in Esau, man. We don't put our faith in Esau. We put our faith in Yahweh Shem Yahushai. Period, point blank. Destruction unto you who run to Egypt for help, because Egypt is that oppressing city. Woe to that oppressing city, okay? Which is America. This is modern day Egypt, all right? This is the book of Psalms. Nine. The Lord also will be a refuge for the oppressed, a refuge in times of trouble. And we're the oppressed. We're the captives in this oppressing city known as Babylon, or Egypt, or Sodom and Gomorrah. Modern America. That's the modern day thing. Okay? This is an oppressing city, and in this oppressing city, we are the oppressed. And the oppressed need to be delivered. And we are going to be delivered. We're going to be delivered when Yahweh Shai returns, man. Okay? The Lord also will be a refuge for the oppressed, a refuge in times of trouble. And they that know thy name will put their trust in thee. For thou, Lord, hast not forsaken them that seek thee. And the Lord ain't going to forsake those that seek thee, man. Okay? The Lord isn't going to forsake the elect. He's going to deliver the elect. But everybody else, the two-thirds, they depend on the so-called white man. That's going to be their destruction too, man. A lot of you Israelites don't even realize you're being set up. You're being casted into that trap, man. Okay? And eventually it's going to be your demise, man. It's going to be your destruction. The scriptures talk about how you Israelites following after your own way really just leads to self-destruction. Okay? Ecclesiastes 4:1. So I returned and considered all the oppressions that are done under the sun, and behold, the tears of such as were oppressed, and they had no comfort. And on the side of their oppressors, there was power, but they had no comfort. Okay, so the Heavenly Father, He sees the tears of the oppressed. And he sees that we don't have, which, okay, we do have the comfort. Okay, the comfort is found in the scriptures through the spirit and power of Yahweh Hashem Yahushai. So typically, yes, the elect of these people have a comforter. Okay? But the Heavenly Father sees that we don't have a comforter, because like I've read in a different verse, it asked how, who's gonna come and ask us how we're doing? Which means nobody. So the Heavenly Father already said there ain't no comfort. If you want help, you got to come to me, because there ain't nobody else that's gonna help you to keep it straight up. Okay, that's just what he's saying. And a lot of people, they have a problem with turning to the Heavenly Father because they want carnal things right away. They don't have the patience, especially when you're dealing with women. Women don't have patience to receive spiritual blessings, because a lot of the blessings that come from the Lord requires patience, man. And that's something women fail to understand. They lack patience. It takes patience to be a decent woman in this society. Okay? You can't be a so-called woman and not be patient. Okay? But nevertheless, the tears of the oppressed, the Lord has his eyes on that, man. And he will eventually deliver the oppressed, the elect. Okay? Because although all the nation of Israel is oppressed, they don't care. The majority of our people don't care about that. And if they do care, they're not calling on the Lord. And that's the main problem. They're not calling on the Lord, nor do they care to. Okay? So I returned and considered all the oppressions that are done under the sun. And behold, the tears of such as were oppressed, and they had no comfort. So that's really what I want to focus on. The tears of the oppressed, and they had no comforter. We do have a comforter, okay? And his name is Yahawashai. All right, I'm gonna close it out with this, matter of fact. For the tears of the oppressed. Revelations 21 and 4. And God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, neither sorrow, nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things are passed away. So in the kingdom, we're not going to ever cry again. Well, we're not going to cry from sadness. In the kingdom, we're going to have tears of joy. We're going to be so happy, it's going to bring tears to our eyes, man. Okay? But we're not going to be crying or sad because we lost a relative, or because we can hardly make ends meet, and the unfair ways of Esau, the so-called white man. That's going to be a thing in the past, okay? Yahawashai is going to wipe away the tears of the oppressed. And we have faith in that. We have hope in that. And Lord willing, you know, in the near future, as more people wake up to this truth, and the sooner we get out of here, those tears can be wiped away, man. We don't have to worry about that ever again, all right? Let's read that one more time before I close it, and we'll end it there. Alright, so this is Revelation 21 and 4 again. And God shall wipe away all the tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, neither sorrow, nor crying. Neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things are passed away. And dying, being oppressed, all of that is going to be a thing in the past, a thing of the past eventually. For these people, the tribes, man. So with that, I want to give all praises to Yahweh Hashem Yahushai, Hashem Rakakodash. Double honors to the elders and the apostles of Great Millstone. Salutations to all the true, sincere brethren around the four corners, pushing out this purified truth, cleansing this wicked, defiled kingdom with the word, and to the rest of the church who believe. And the water to Yahawashai, because without that man, none of this would even be possible whatsoever. Shalom.